This guitar interactive feature is brought to you by Moore Effects and Amplification.
Hi, Sam Bell here at Guitar Interactive magazine, and I'm here today with Brandon and Tyler from Goodbye June, and they're here at the O2 Kentish Forum in Camden supporting Greta Van Fleet on their tour. So, hi guys, how's it going?
Hey, what's
great,
up?
Great. We're having a good time in London. Mm-hmm. First time here. It's a great city.
Awesome. Beautiful city.
So you did a bit of sightseeing before we got started today with sound check?
A little bit, yeah. A little bit. I did the hop on, hop off. Mostly hopped on.
Yeah.
You know, not many hop offs, but yeah. We had a great time.
Is this awesome. Your first time in the UK as a band?
It is,
playing?
It is. Got to see the changing of the guard today, which is absolutely incredible. It makes me wish our government was that prestigious. And we kind of have a weird time right now. But anyways, we can forget all about that. But it was really awesome to see and all the history and everything. So
cool.
Really happy to be here.
So you've come over. Where are you guys based? Is it Nashville?
I
read.
Nashville, Tennessee.
And how long's the band been together as this unit? Who's the brainchild?
We're all first cousins. We grew up together. So the me, Landon, and Brandon, the lead singer, and then me and Brandon, we're all first cousins. And we started playing music quite a while back. Yeah. I mean, this Goodbye June started 2005, 2000.
We put our first independent record out in 2012.
Okay.
I guess you could say we kind of officially got professionally going in 2012.
Sure.
But we've been playing together our entire lives pretty much, off and on. In church. That's where we cut our teeth, and playing in church. So
it's important to have that kind of sort of relationship within the band where you can just get together and just create and play, and
absolutely.
There's no kind of awkwardness. It sounds like it's a natural occurring kind of band.
It was. Yeah. I mean, the way it all came about was even more so, I guess, natural in a way. Tyler's older brother, he passed in a car accident.
Mm-hmm. And so then they came up for the about a month. Landon and Brandon had come up and just to support me and my family through that time. And we ended up playing a lot of music, in my basement, my parents' basement.
Yeah, yeah.
So we ended up, setting up guitars and just kind of playing. And we had never really played music together. We ended up writing a couple songs. And it was a lot. We were having so much fun, so it just kind of kept going,
Yeah.
And so that's why the name, Goodbye June, it's my brother passed in June, so that was the reason why we named the band Goodbye June. Because we started playing shows, and we're like, well, what are we called? And I think you came up with it.
We're throwing around some stuff, and we were trying to figure out something to kind of memorialize him because he's such a big influence in our lives. As far as, I mean, he was Tyler's big brother, but he was a big brother to a lot of people. And he, like I said, huge influence in our life. And he was there to push you in any way, shape, or form, just to be sort of the best person you can be. I feel like.
Okay.
So anyway, we named the band up.
It's a nice heartfelt.
Yeah. And we're all family, so I don't know. This is kind of what the band's all about.
Yeah. Family. Yeah. Well, I was going to say as well about influences of your sounds and where you'll come from musically in terms of the sound. I listened to the first album. Mm-hmm. And then you got a recent EP which came out. What's the name of the new EP then, was it?
The new EP is called Secrets in the Sunset.
Yeah.
And then our first record we released on Interscope Records, and that was on, it's called Magic Valley. Okay. That was 2017, and then this year we released Secrets in the Sunset.
Cool. And where would you say your influences come from your sounds? I mean, there's all sorts of things. You've got this great slide pedal steel thing going on with the 335 of the telly. Is that a thin line?
It's modeled after a thin line. It's actually a Nash guitar. It's kind of like a custom shop kind of guitar, I guess you could say.
Yeah, it's a custom builder in Nashville. Mm-hmm. He just makes guitars. A lot of people play them around Nashville, and he makes great guitars. So
it's modeled after a 72, like thin line.
Okay,
that's my main one. Of course, the black one's a solid body, but my one that I love the most is the wood grain. But I've been playing the black one more lately for some reason. But anyways, But as far as influences, I mean, Tyler grew up CCR. His dad listened to CCR all the time.
Yeah.
Landon and I, we grew up in the church hardcore, so we're talking like black gospel, old just choir music.
Yeah,
you
church
know?
Hymns.
And then later on, we kind of got into, like, you know, like Nirvana and Metallica when we were little kids.
Yeah.
We had to, like, sneak that stuff into our rooms to listen, because our parents, they weren't going to have that, you know.
Right.
Because it was the devil's music.
Okay.
So, but yeah, we had all kinds of influences, honestly. And then later on, you know, like Zeppelin and Pink Floyd. I mean, the Beatles. It's just a wide range of things. We just love good music.
Awesome.
You know.
Yeah.
I was going to say there was quite a, probably the wrong word, but it's like more classic rootsy rock sound than some like more modern rock going around, but with your own sort of stint on it and how you guys play and how you put all those sounds, and you got all the pedal, you got like, you had a shimmer sort of, is that a Strymon style?
Are you talking about the delay? The reverse? I bought that in a shop. It's an Empress pedal. Empress Super Delay.
Okay.
And I literally only use it for one or two. It has like 100 types of delays. I use it for that reverse delay that you're talking about, that kind of shimmer.
Yeah.
That's on Blindly Follow Blindly, one of our songs from the EP. And I use that. And I use it for a tape delay. You know?
Yeah.
It's got a really good tape delay sound. So
it's a great pedal.
Yeah.
So talking about that, sort of getting inspired by the gear and the sounds and past influences, how about the writing process for... as a band, how does it work? You all throw in song ideas? Does it start with lyrics? Does it start with what's the general?
I feel like the majority of the time it usually starts with a musical idea, but it happens all different ways. I mean, like, you might have a thought and like some lyrics that he's been working through, or Tyler come in with a riff, or I'll come in with a musical idea, and just all three come together and kind of develop it and grow it together. It's a very collaborative effort, and that's what we've always wanted.
Yeah.
You know, we don't ever want one person like, this is all mine, you know, because there are bands like that, and I don't, for me, I couldn't do that. You know what I mean? And it's not an ego thing, it's just everyone needs to be involved to a certain degree because you're a band, you know, you're not a solo artist, you know, so.
Yeah. I think, like, on the new EP, to elaborate a little bit more on just how this last EP came about. I know I was kind of brought together the chords and some ideas, some of the lyric ideas of Blindly Follow Blindly, and then the guys kind of came in and helped me build the chorus of it. And then Brandon had he had a lot of the music to Live in the Now, like he kind of had it all mapped out in his head, and we'd come in and massaged it, you know, one way or another, and started writing some lyrics to it. And Landon, I think he had a couple chords, and he wrote Get Happy. You know, he wrote like a verse and chorus, you know, of it. And then we just, you know, so it kind of happens all different ways, but we always try to involve each other. And because we all play so differently, it's kind of fun to see where your idea can go when you give it in the hands of Landon or Brandon, you know, as far as like drums or bass or, you know, what they, you know, hey, try this chord or try this melody. Or, you know, it's just fun. That's how this EP was, and it's a lot of fun.
Great, awesome. Yeah. So what's the plan after this tour then? Do you know what's going to happen, or do another?
What's the holidays coming up?
Holidays are coming up. I think we're probably going to be back to the studio and probably either A, finish the other side of Seekers in the Sunset, like another 5 or 6 tunes, or it could be a full-length record. It's kind of up in the air right now as far as what we're going to do. So it really depends on what happens in the studio, honestly. Like, if we get in there and start firing all cylinders and everyone's like, oh yeah, keep going, then maybe a full-length record. But
so it's quite an organic process as a band, and from the roots to where you are now. It's just natural and feels good.
We worked a lot with our first record. Our producer was Paul Moak, who's a great collaborator, and he owns an amazing studio in Nashville. And then he collaborated with us on one song on the new EP, but we worked with another producer called Bobby Huff, and we were in his studio, and we were just showing him some songs, and we ended up just started recording, and then all of a sudden we were looking at an EP, you know, it's like, this is pretty good, and it all, you know, makes sense together, and it was a new... I felt like it was a breath of fresh air for us as a band, like these five songs. And so we're like, hey, let's package it. And we had this tour coming up. Mm-hmm. So it just
worked out perfectly.
It just started, you know, the artwork came together quickly. And it's like, hey, let's package this, put it in an EP, and let's sell it in Europe. Why not? So, you know, it worked great. So
great, man. Well, another question I ask this for most interviews is advice. especially for musicians, guitarists who are looking at either being in a band or writing original music. Yeah. So from your perspectives, what would you, what advice would you give? Maybe even to like a younger self, or maybe just
younger self? Oh man. Well, you have to write 100 songs and write 100 more if you want to be a songwriter. And if you think they're good at the time, well, they're probably not. And don't get emotionally attached to your work necessarily. I mean, you need to be emotionally attached to it, but like you can't be afraid to step outside of it and say, well, that wasn't good enough. And you also need to sit down and play for hours and hours until you figure out the exact structures of songs, because there's a lot of times that one song, Live in the Now, I played that song probably 30 different ways before I was like, this is exactly how I want it to be. And a younger self, I would say, take guitar lessons. You know, we didn't take guitar lessons. We were self-taught. We could have had a much faster, maybe, track, perhaps. But it's okay to learn from other people, you know. Don't be egotistical.
Okay, you know? Good advice.
I think something I always struggle with, that I've come in to my own in the last, you know, 5 years, kind of since we, since Magic Valley, is that I think every guitar player has, if you really try, you can have your own voice. Mm-hmm. You don't have to sound like someone else. Mm-hmm. You can be inspired and influenced, and you can learn the way other people play. But everyone has their own voice, and I think that's something that I think maybe gets lost, or gets you know, maybe somebody's scared to play a certain way because they, you know, it sounds weird or whatever. Mm-hmm. As long as it's musical and as long as it's honest, I think you. You know, sometimes you need to learn, you know, you need to learn all the, you know, take lessons and get and have the skill set and have the tools in your toolkit. But I think it's really about doing that, but also finding your own voice, because that's what matters. That's the art you can bring to the world that's unique, that no one else can bring, is what is inside. You know, so
I think we can all, as musicians, sort of think about our influences, and most of them, the ones that last the longest in your life and mean the most, and often the most uniquest. Stand out in their own ways.
Yeah, for sure.
Adjectives like odd or weird. Yeah. You know, you might describe some of your favorite guitar parts or whatever. You know, I mean, George Harrison's incredible. You know, at those cool little quirky little lead lines that, you know, it's.
It was his own.
It was his own
voice,
right?
Like
you
said. And you said, I mean, honesty. That's a huge thing.
Yeah.
You got to be. There's a lot of cookie cutter things out there right now. There's a lot of. There's a lot of fake out there right now. I mean, there's a lot of computer drums, you know, on tracks you hear all the time, and that takes all of the originality out of it, like, or keyboard bass. I mean, it's really happening right now in rock and roll. It's really sad. But you got bands like Greta Van Fleet, bands like us, our buddies Bad Flower.
It's what you hear. You hear,
It's real, it's honest music, and you can tell the difference.
Yeah. So. Awesome. Well, keep fighting that good fight, because I'm in the same boat as well. Like, it has to be, like, tone and just natural sounds are kind of like eye color, almost.
Exactly.
It's completely unique to everybody, and that's what makes music special.
So. Indeed, absolutely. Yeah.
Well, guys, thank you for your time. It's been
a
pleasure.
Anytime.
Thank you.
Good luck tonight. It's sounding wicked. I'm a new fan, so.
Wow. Man, are you staying or sticking around for the show?
We'll try to, yes.
Cool.
Yes, yeah.
You should, man.
Yeah, man.
Have your brewski.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah.
All right, Sam Bell here at Guitar Interactive Magazine with Tyler and Brandon from Goodbye June. Go check them out, and we'll see you soon at Guitar Interactive Magazine.
Cheers.